and welcome to 8th episode of LT Live, bringing you more productivity and safety on construction job site. I am Akash, your digital account manager, connecting with you all live via Facebook. What you just saw in the coring process is a common story on all construction job site. And now, do let us know in the comment section below that which tool I was using when I was doing coring, and let's see who gets the right answer first. Because what I will be doing is, I will be using my mobile phone like the last episode, wherein I will be reading out your comments and replying to all of you directly on live session. So do let us know which tool I am using today for coring process. And now, I am sure all of you can relate what I was just doing. I was doing diamond drilling, which is also called as core cutting. And the purpose is, you make holes in a slab or a concrete wall to pass your plumbing pipes, HVAC ducts, or maybe cable trays. And what you have seen is, firstly, in doing so, what you do is you waste a lot of water in the process. But more importantly, the bigger question is, do you find water on different floors, on different locations of job site so easily? Do let us know in the comment section below that how challenging and how difficult it is to find water on a construction job site when you are performing coring. In fact, what we have seen is, more than the water, you also waste a lot of time. A study shows that 30% of time in the coring process goes only in finding water on the job site and then later on cleaning the slurry. Mainly the reasons are, first, the limited availability of water source on the job site, that is a tap, very difficult to find. And if you are working on an infra project like road project or tunnel project, then it's almost impossible. Then secondly, what you do is, you use these long hoses, and then sometimes the length is 100 meters, 200 meters, taking it to different floors, different location is tedious. But moreover, guys, so many a times you need to connect two hoses together, and there's a lot of water leakage that happens in between the way, where you lose almost 40 to 50% of water on the way. Then thirdly, what we have seen is, if you are not using these long hoses, what you do is, you bring a bucket or a water tank, in which there's one more guy involved who pumps the water inside the motor, and then it becomes a two-man operation. And finally, what we have seen is that if you are working in an operational building where you need to ensure cleanliness, you have to clean all the slurry and dispose it later on, which again takes a lot of time. And now I am sure you all agree to me and type in yes in the comment section below if you also face similar kind of challenges while doing core cutting on the job site. And let me see your comments. So I am going live now. And I can read the comments. Sachin says it is difficult to manage water in high-rise building. Yes, especially if you are working on 20 floor or 30 floor building, taking water from the ground to the 20th floor where the elevators are not working when it is at the construction phase, it is too difficult. And Tamboli says, love to see the awareness. Thanks, Tamboli. And Bhagwan says he has tagged someone. And guys, do let us know if you face similar kind of challenges. Type in yes in the comment section below. And now I can see many of you say yes, you also face similar kind of challenges while performing coring. And now, what if I tell you, we have a solution for you by which you can avoid all the challenges that we just discussed. And the solution is Hilti WMS-100. Firstly, it provides you full water autonomy throughout the day by recycling the water, which means you do not need to struggle to find water sources on the job site. Secondly, it gives you cleaner job site, which means you do not need to clear on slurry later on and dispose it, saving time. And finally, it's a single man operation, so you do not need one more guy to pump in water inside the motor. And now, let me explain some of its features and how to use WMS along with coring tool. By the way, guys, do you know what does WMS 100 stands for? WMS is water management system, since it manages the water, it recycles it. But the 100 part, 100 is 100 liters of water output that you get through this tool, which means you do not need to find out water every day on the job site. You just use this and then that's it. And now let's see it from inside. So this is the way you open the lid. And over here, you can see there's a water tank. And you can see the limit of the water tank is also mentioned, the maximum mark. And the capacity of this water tank is 14 liters. And now, you would be wondering that I just said the output is 100 liters. And now I am saying capacity of tank is only 14 liters. How is it possible? And this is the beauty of WMS 100, that it recycles the water at least 7 times, which means you get a minimum water output of 100 liters, which you can use throughout the day. So the first step is you need to fill 14 liters of water inside the water tank. And the step number 2 is there's a filter bag which comes along with WMS 100 that you need to connect over here. And there's a slit, you have to just put it like this and that's it, you are ready to go. And the purpose of filter bag is it collects all the slurry from the coring when you are doing. It collects all the slurry and all the water gets drained back inside the water tank. And now we put back the lid again. And that's it. You see how easy it is to use WMS 100. Now it is ready to use. But one more thing. Guys, this is a very intelligent machine. And when I say that it's an intelligent machine, the reason being is that it automatically tells you if the water level is too less or if the water level is too much. Moreover, if your filter beds get full, it will again give you a signal. How? Let me tell you. You see there's an indicator over here. Over here, it will show you if the water level is minimum. Over here, it will show you if the water level is maximum or if the filter bag is full. And that's how it automatically communicates to you. And now, let's use WMS 100 along with DD160 tool that we are using today. So what we have to do is we have to connect these water hoses. And this one is to be connected over here. And the second one, the larger dia, you fix it over here. So the smaller dia hose is the one which is connected with DD160. It provides the water that is in the water container to the DD motor, which you will be using. And the second hose, which is having the larger dia, the other connection, you have to connect with the water collector ring. This is again part of WMS 100 kit. And this is what we'll be using to collect all the slurry. And right now the core dia is 100 mm. So you can see the dia of water collector ring is 122 mm. We have these rings available in different sizes. As per the core dia, you can choose that which one to use. And now let's turn on WMS 100 and use it. So you can see over here, there is a vacuum that it creates and it automatically sticks wherever you need to do the coring. And that's it. And now we turn on the water. And let me put back my earplugs. And you can see that water has started falling and now we are ready to go. You see how easily I was able to do core cutting using Hilti DD WMS 100 without wasting any water. And now you would be wondering where is the slurry and water gone. So let me show you. So you can see over here, the filter bag, all the slurry we have collected inside this filter bag, and the all the water that was there in the slurry has come back inside the water tank. And therefore, you can use this water again and again throughout the day for doing other number of course. And this is what our aim at Hilti is, that a single man can set up the tool, do the coring throughout the day without struggling to find water and having cleaner job sites. And not only water, we also discussed how you save time, which means you can do more number of cores in a day if you save time. For example, if you are doing right now 12 to 30 number of cores in a day, using WMS-100, you can do almost 18 to 100 number of cores. Therefore, if you are doing a job, let's say in 30 days, you can complete in 20 days, saving 10 days of time, therefore saving money. And that is the reason you must try Hilti DD WMS-100 along with core cutting machine if you are into these kind of jobs. Do let us know in the comment section below if you need a demo at your job site, and we would love to come at your place and do the demo. Also, we have posted a link in the description of the video below from where you can download the catalog of DD WMS-100. So do not forget to click on that. And that's it from my side in today's episode. I hope you enjoyed the live session. It was an amazing experience to interact with you all. Next episode, we will be coming up with another Hilti innovation, where we're talking about Hilti multi-line insert portfolio along with one of the product manager. So stay tuned, stay safe. Till then, take care of yourself and see you all in the next episode.